This year we're organizing the first annual Latin Soul Arts Festival, which is basically an exploration of Latin art and culture here at Boston College. It's the first year we've celebrated Hispanic Heritage Month as a university initiative, and we have support from over 30 different departments and offices on campus. Today, we really wanted to make it a fun night for students to just get together, hear some spoken word, hear some poetry, check out some Latin dance, hear Latin music, try Latin food. Well, I think it's important to celebrate Latin American culture because it's important. I mean, we're becoming a globalized society, and it's important that we become tolerant, that we appreciate other cultures, that we learn from each other, and that there's a mutual respect between students. And I really think events like these, cultural events like these, and arts events like these, really know how to bring the community together. A lot to gain when you intersect of culture and education, and I really think Boston College is doing a great job at doing that with this festival.
Those unfamiliar yet familiar, those handy and embracing, going beyond history and blood, skin color, eyes, personality, beyond the word biological. Red hands, black hands, yellow hands, white hands. Now that is family.
No te amo como si fueras rosa de sal, topacio, o flecha de claveles que propagan el fuego.
I do not love you as if you were a rose made of salt or topaz, or an arrow of carnation spreading fire.
We're going to establish this now. I'm Haitian. I'm Haitian American. And in my culture, a storyteller cannot begin her story without the audience's permission. So I see you and you see me, right? So when I say click, you have to say clap. Then I can tell the story, okay? Click!
Wow.
Click!
Wow.
Roxy, fresh from the Dominican Republic, lives on the first floor. And me, a Haitian, talking American, I live on the third. She's 12 years old and I'm 9, but we're friends because neither of us is allowed to go outside. There is no play for the daughters of immigrants who rest under project ceilings. We are our parents' only investments. In their dreams, we birth second-story houses in the suburbs, strong fences and theftless streets, Jewish neighbors walking well-groomed dogs, graffiti-less two-car-door garages. There is no room in our parents' fantasies for the brown folks of our dreary daily lives who work or loiter or love or die around us, who don't know coconuts and guava, mango and quenepas, who don't muse over lost motherlands and ancestral languages the way we do.